Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. A David and Goliath story right in front of us here in New Hampshire. New Hampshire auto dealers taking on the U.S. auto manufacturers over rights. And here's what I mean. Legislation has passed both the New Hampshire Senate and New Hampshire House. Expansion of the Dealer Bill of Rights, which has been on the books in New Hampshire, but this is an expansion. It limits mandatory upgrades to every 15 years. Currently, automakers mandate renovations without any limit on time or cost. Local dealers can now buy local instead of out of state. And here's some more. It ensures adequate reimbursement for warranty work by the auto dealers, controls on inventory and sales decisions by the automakers, and transparency between the automakers and local auto dealers to give dealers more of an even hand in negotiations. With me to talk about this are two people who helped usher this through the New Hampshire Legislature. They are Pete McNamara, President of the New Hampshire Automobile Dealers Association. Pete, welcome.
Thank you, Fred.
And Donna Hosmer, who is owner of AutoServe Dealer Group. And you're in Tilton, Belmont, and Plymouth, right?
That's right.
Welcome.
Thanks for having us.
Nice to have you. Pete, what's the case you made to legislators to expand this Bill of Rights?
Well, right now, it's a one-sided relationship between car dealers and car manufacturers. Yeah. It's a take-it-or-leave-it contract that they have. Mm-hmm. And the manufacturers over the past several years have been demanding new facilities every 5 to 7 years. And so what the legislature agreed to was, let's give them local control, let's let dealers buy local, and let's have more transparency in the relationship between car dealers and car manufacturers.
Donna, what kind of mandates were you experiencing? You have several brands of cars that you sell, right?
Yes, we do, Fred. We have Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Volkswagen, Nissan, and Kia. And in our case, Nissan, within the last few years, had asked us to build a brand new facility and at a cost of well in excess of $1 million. And just more recently, we remodeled our Volkswagen showroom at a cost of in excess of $300,000.
And I understand you had to frost the windows between two of the dealerships so one wouldn't be looking at the other.
Yes, they like their separate space. That's a big emphasis with the manufacturer's exclusivity.
So $1 million, I mean, that has to come out of your budget, and do they give you time to budget for it or not?
Well, no, not really. They hold the cards, and we need to adhere, and that was a part of why we needed to press for this legislation. Dealers across New Hampshire are being forced to remodel.
Now, Pete, this has been on the books for, you said, 40 years.
Correct.
But now this is an expansion of the Dealer Bill of Rights.
Right.
How does this help consumers who come to buy the cars?
Well, you just look at the cost factors right now. On average, we found it costs dealers $3.5 million to upgrade their facility. So if you're doing this every 5 years, yeah, it's going to cost $500 million every 5 years for dealers to upgrade, and that's going to flow right down to consumers. With the law that says every 15 years now they can mandate update, that's ultimately going to save consumers money.
Okay. Now, the Alliance of Automobile Manufacturers fought this. National Group fought this big time, as much as you were promoting it, and they say this could go to court. What say you?
Well, it's gone to court several times in New Hampshire and in Maine, and the courts have agreed every single time that it's constitutional under the U.S. and federal, the state and federal constitutions.
Uh-huh. Other states have this law, Donna? Other states, all states?
Every state, all 50 states have a Dealer Bill of Rights.
They do.
Absolutely.
And they've been on the books for years.
For ours, in our case, over 40 years.
So why is it that the national manufacturers have such a reach into the dealerships with laws on the books?
Well, it's their practices change. The relationships evolve over time. And this image program is relatively new, where manufacturers have come out and asked dealers to spend money after we've just come out of a difficult recession. And dealers don't attach the return on investment to the mandates that we're being made to adhere to. We don't know that building these facilities will sell any more cars.
Right, right. Has the governor going to sign this, Pete?
I believe that she will. We've worked with her and her staff as the bill went through the process. The legislature made a lot of changes to it and made it a better bill.
Well, you certainly got a big vote in the House, 338-30, and in the Senate, 21-2. You've got some friends in the legislature. I want to thank both of you, Donna Hosmer, who is owner of AutoServe Dealer Group, and Pete McNamara, president of the New Hampshire Automobile Dealers Association.
Thanks, Fred.
Thank you.
And you can see this interview again at WMUR.com. Click on News and then click on Project Economy.